Spandana. Over to you, Spandana.
Hello, everyone. So today we are going to see Greece, which is a very, very, very old country and has a very rich history of more than thousands of years. And it is called...
I believe it's older than India.
India is, Indus civilization is the oldest, one of the oldest. Greece is also almost the same, actually. Mesopotamia civilization is the oldest in the world. But after that, okay, it's Indus Valley civilization. So India will be the more older country.
Okay.
It is also called as a birthplace for Western civilization, actually. And like Western literature, culture, and many more. So let me show you the map. Okay, so this is Europe, continent, and in that, can you recognize Greece over here? Can you see my laser, this one, point?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So it's near Africa and Asia also. It is in Greece, Europe, but it's nearby. So it's like a crossroads of Europe, Asia, and Africa. It shares land borders with Albania. I'll show you that in the next slide. Albania and North Macedonia, Bulgaria and Turkey. See, this is Greece and its land borders are shared nearby like Turkey, Bulgaria and all those things, right? So, and also you can see Aegean Sea and Ionian Sea and also Athens, which is the capital city of Greece. It's a very famous city. So,
and I know about this Black Sea.
Yes, Black Sea. Yes, yes, yes. You can tell me about it later. I'll show you the Greek island so you can tell me about that, okay? So about Greece, it has 11th longest coastline, which means it has a coastal line which is very long, in the like 11th longest in the world. And it has almost so many islands, of which 227 are inhabited, which means in 227 islands, people live there. Okay, and 80% of Greece is mountainous. That's mountain ranges are so many, mountain ranges are there. And then there is coastline, which are more beaches, seas, and all those things.
Yes, all my facts.
Yes?
You said all my facts.
Oh, it's all right. It's all right. You can repeat it again later. Okay.
Ma'am.
So, yes, Ansh.
Greece is also known for its beaches, right?
Greece is also known for its
beaches.
Yes, it is. There are some beautiful beach over there. So, as you know, capital of the Greece is Athens. So, what is it famous for? Do you know anything about Athens? Okay.
Athens.
Yes, Sudarshan.
City of Violet Crown is Athens.
Okay, yes. It's also the largest city of Greece and it is one of the world's oldest cities also. And it is the birthplace of democracy. You know democracy, right? How India and all are ruling today. We select the people who want to govern our country. Before that, only king's rule was there. But Athens is the place where the birth of democracy started. And of course, we cannot forget the Olympics, right? Where is the Olympics held right now? Where is it going on?
Tokyo.
Yes, very good. So, this is the place where Olympics actually started, which is one of the world's biggest sporting event actually. And it is called as Ancient Olympics.
I actually watch it with my dad.
That's great. So, you know who won India, medal for India, right?
So, the history of Olympics. That also Athens was the main one.
Yes. So it dates back very, very long ago. And then in 1896, modern Olympics, which Olympics you can see right now, that started in 1896. And
because the ancient Olympics came to a sudden end. Somewhere.
Yes, because of the Roman emperor who invaded there, he put a ban on this Olympics game. He didn't want it to continue. That's why
of the world wars and all that was
that
also
too,
happening.
That too, yeah. That is after the modern Olympics started. It was come into halt during World War. And after that, obviously, during the pandemic, it went 1 year further. So in 2004, again, Athens hosted the Olympics, which was a very proud moment to Greece. Obviously, it will be a proud moment, right? Because that is the country which started Olympics and they get to host it again. So this is Athens. And next, okay, there are few good things about to say here. So these are a few of the words which you can commonly see in Greek mythology or whenever you revisit the Greek history. Okay, so first one is columns, which is also called as pillars, which are main part of all the Greek palace and temples. Greek architecture is very famous and it's especially for its beautiful columns or pillars. And Acropolis, the second one, which you can see over here, is the place of Athens. It's an ancient citadel, which means like a fort. Okay, and it contains some of the ancient buildings of the great architecture of Greek. And one of them is Parthenon, which is over here. Okay, Parthenon is a former temple, which it was a temple before, and on the Acropolis, and it was dedicated to goddess Athena. So I'll tell you about the Greek mythology. Okay, so I really, really love Greek mythology. Has any of you read any Greek mythology before?
No, ma'am.
No?
No, ma'am.
Okay, it's very interesting.
I just heard that before, now how in the Olympics we get gold medals, that they used to give all the olive leaf crowns.
Okay, so how we have mythologies, right? We know so many gods. We have so many gods, even Hindu gods, Christian gods, and many gods, right? Same thing, same way, they have also gods in their own land and all. But now they have adopted, they don't worship them as we worship still. So it's all become a story right now, okay? So this Parthenon is a temple dedicated to goddess Athena. She is the goddess of wisdom and war. That's why the name of the city, Athens, comes from, okay? So next is like self-explanatory. These are shield, helmets, and soldiers. This is man and woman. They have shown you. They are wearing a chiton, which is a dress which they used to wear during their...
Most of the things started in Greece, like maths and science, all that
yes,
started
with yes, Greece. Yes. But all these famous people like Aristotle and Dante, they were all over there actually. They all, so it's pretty famous over there. That's why it's called as, it's a birthplace for many of the civilization, culture, literature and all those things. So this is lyre, it's a musical instrument. And mythological creatures, this is interesting. So mythology is like something that is not real right now. It's only in the stories. So Greek mythology has so many mythological creatures. One which you can see over here is called a centaur. Do you know what centaur is?
No, I heard it for the first
time. Yes, a centaur is a creature with half a body of a horse and half a body of a man.
Yes, yes, it has half a body of a man and the lower body is of a horse. So one more mythological creature they have is a three-headed dog, actually, like a giant dog. It is a dog, it is a animal which is a gatekeeper for the underworld, or what we call as hell. They call it as underworld, where the god. Yes.
Oof, imagine this was real.
Yes. You know, have you seen Harry Potter before?
Yes, I've seen
the biggest Potterhead in the world.
Yes, so if you have first Harry Potter movie,
centaurs are major characters and Fluffy is also there.
Yes, Fluffy has three-headed dog, right? So that is inspired by this actually, Cerberus. So it's a very famous mythological creature. So it takes care of the underworld. It's a gatekeeper for the underworld. Okay. So
no,
the next
slimy in saliva.
Yes. So Olympics, obviously, I have already explained. So Poseidon, these are the gods, okay? So first of all, I'll explain Zeus. Zeus is the king of gods. So how we have you heard of God Indra in Indian mythology? God
yes, Indra. I have heard.
Yeah, same thing. Yes. Zeus is the gods of the god, okay? In Greek mythology, he is the god of sky, thunder, and lightning. And this is Poseidon. He is the brother of Zeus. He is the god of sea, water, earthquake, and all those things. Okay, and horses also. And One more brother is Hades. He is the god of death and he is the king of underworld. How we call Yama, you know? Yama, god Yama. Same thing like Hades over there. Okay. So this is a flag. National flag.
Oh, this is only the flag I was going to say.
Yeah, you explain. What you have written?
What?
You have written some fact about this flag?
Not about the flag.
Mm-hmm.
I've not written about the flag.
Okay. Let me explain. So it's popularly referred to as blue and white and has 9 equal horizontal stripes like this. And a white cross. Cross represents the Christianity religion, which is still in Greece. They follow Christianity.
I've heard about Greece, but I've not seen its flag.
So now you have seen it. Because if it is about Olympics, there will be some reference to Greece. So you can see this now when you're seeing the Olympics. Okay. The next one is currency. Obviously, since it's in Europe, their currency is also euro.
Euros.
So 1 euro is
every country in Europe except for England, except for UK, has the euro currency.
That is because have you heard of Brexit recently?
No.
Okay. I don't want to complicate it, but it is a European Union, so they have same currency all throughout the European Union. But recently UK came out of it, so they want their own currency, they want their own and all those things. That's why, that's the reason. Okay, if you want to know more, it's complicated, but you can read it in the internet. Okay, so this is the president who is the head of a state. Her name is Katrina Sakellaropoulou, and she's a Greek politician and the current president of Greece. So the language they speak is official language, which is Greek, and about 99% of the population speak that. And the most common foreign languages are English, German, French, and Italian. So like what we say, ABCD, they use alpha, beta, gamma. If you're studying science, have you come across all this alpha, beta, gamma in maths and science? Yeah, right?
No.
No?
I'm still in second.
Oh, second standard. Okay. I think when you go to sixth standard, at least, you will come to know about alpha, beta, gamma. They use this alpha, beta, gamma, and delta. These four are mostly used in maths and science. Okay. So they use Greek letters for that.
A is alpha, B is beta, no?
You will learn about it. It's very, very in-depth, actually. So mostly in maths and science. Okay, so usually alpha is the like a main, beta will be the second person, like that. Okay, second level, like that. Okay, when you say 1, 2, 3, something similar like that, it's not totally in that way, but in English, when you're saying it's somewhat similar. So gods of Greece, I'll give you a brief introduction. Zeus, as I said, king of gods, okay, god of sky. Poseidon is a god of sea, river, flood. Hestia is a goddess of hearth, home. Hera is the queen of gods. That is the wife of Zeus. She is the goddess of marriage, woman, and childbirth. So this is just a cartoon depiction where all the cartoons are shown as girls, actually. But many of the names over gods over here are male originally. So like Hades, he is the king of death or a god of death. Ares is the god of war. He is not very well known. He likes to make war. That's why people don't worship him too much, Ares, okay? Dionysus is a god of wine and grapefruit. Demeter is the goddess of agriculture. Hephaestus is a god of fire and blacksmith. He is one who forges all the weapons to all the gods, okay? He makes one of the greatest weapons according to their mythology. Hera is the goddess of the gods, like the wife of Zeus, and she's also goddess of marriage. Zeus is the king of gods. Yeah, and Aphrodite, she is known to be the most beautiful goddess of love. And Chaos is the goddess of night. Helios is the goddess of sun, god of sun. Athena, as I said, Athens' name came from Athena. She is the goddess of war and wisdom. She is known to be the most knowledgeable about war. She is the tactical one. Okay, so the Apollo and Artemis, these two, Athena, Apollo, Artemis, Zeus, Hera, Poseidon, they are the main gods. They are, okay, usually you see when you read the stories. Apollo is a god of music, and also he's a god of archery, prophecy, healing. And Artemis is the twin sister of Apollo. She's the goddess of hunt and protector of young girls. So it's like when if you consider Apollo as the sun, she is the moon. Hermes is the messenger god. Have you heard of the Narada? We call messenger or messenger in our mythology. Have you heard of Narada?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Something similar to that. Hermes. Yes, Hermes is the god of messenger god. Okay. And Poseidon, as I told you, he's a god of sea. So, see, you can see
why are they all girls in this?
Yeah, that's what I told, because this is a cartoon depiction. They have given it as all the girls, but most of them are males in this. Okay. But if you see, you can make out, right, that in the all this oldest civilization, their stories almost are similar. Like we have the gods of God, like Indra, they have Zeus. We have Yama as the god of death. They have Hades.
They have Hades.
Yeah, similar, little bit similar, but obviously they have some different stories altogether and we have different stories, but the ideology is the same. Okay. So some of the places to visit, we'll see that. Okay. So the Greek islands, these are the beautiful islands. They have some of the most famous tourist spot. This is the most famous.
I had one thing to say about the gods.
Yes, yes, Prakar.
DC and Marvel franchises are mainly based on the gods in this in the Greek mythologies. Because if you search for some comics there, you'll find Zeus, you'll find Ares, you'll find everyone there.
Yeah, but they haven't mentioned any Greek gods exactly, but they have taken the idea from that.
No, I directly use them. For example, there's Medusa there.
Where was she?
She's in the Injustice storyline of DC.
Really?
Comics.
I don't remember it very much exactly.
I've read almost all of the comics Marvel and DC ever made. So
okay,
I remember that Zeus exists in both universes. Hades, Aphrodite, Athena.
Yes, yes.
All of these exist. Even
some might relate to that also, yes.
Yeah, yes. So that's what taught me my Greek mythology. Yeah.
So you have heard of Hercules, I think. He's a very famous hero.
Yeah, even he's a part of both Marvel and DC.
Yes. So if you read Greek stories, you will find many things. So Abir, you had something to say about Dead Sea, right?
Not Dead Sea. I was just saying I know about the Black Sea.
Okay. So these are the Greek islands, which are pretty famous. So what I was showing was this place. It's a shipwrecked place. Okay. So it's the most famous photo op place. So people go there to take photo near the wrecked
ship. It's a shipwreck?
Yes. See, it's a small island and there is nothing over there. Only one ship, but it's a very famous place to go and take a photo of.
You mean it's a above water shipwreck or below water?
Yes, yes. The ship is over there, abandoned over there.
Acha, then it's a dock.
Yeah. But there is it's
underwater.
Yeah.
The shipwrecks must be underwater, of course.
Yeah, okay, yeah. All right. So the next place is Meteora. Is the Greek word Meteora means suspended in the air. And this phrase aptly describes the spectacular cliffs that rise more than 1,200 feet into the air, overlooking the villages of Kalambaka and Kastraki, which is in the Greece. And in this region of almost monks have settled there. Okay, in these places are called as columns of the sky from 11th century. And I'll show you. This is now a UNESCO World Heritage Site because it's so valuable and it has so much history. That's why it's a UNESCO World Heritage Site right now. So the next one is Delphi. So second of the Acropolis, I have told you Acropolis, right? It has one of the ancient architectures of Athens and Greece. So Delphi is Greece's most popular archaeological site, located about 2.5 hours from Athens. And Delphi was once revered, like she was worshipped by the ancient Greeks as the center of the earth. Because she dedicated to God Apollo, Delphi was an important oracle. So do you know oracle? Oracle is a priest or priestess acting as a medium between the god and the people. She used to give prophecy, that is what will happen in the future. She used to give those things from the what she hears from the god, and she used to tell it to the people. That's why she was worshipped a lot. So this place is dedicated to her and god Apollo, who is the god of prophecy. Okay, so we are discussing about Greek food. You must have heard Greek salad and all those, right? Greek salad is pretty famous, and moussaka is an
and olive oil is very famous.
Olive oil. Yes.
They drink olive
tree is the national tree of Greek, actually, because they believe that goddess of wisdom, that is Athena, gave them olive tree. That's why. So this is moussaka, cefado, gyroscopia, fish grill, pistachio, calamari, locomades, and souvlaki. Calamari is a seafood. It's basically a squid, which you can see in the one of the seafood.
Most famous are the first two, Greek salad and moussakas.
Yes, it is actually. So this is pita. Pita bread is also pretty famous. Okay.
I love to have pita bread, actually.
Yes, it's tasty. So, okay. No, before that.
And there are nearly 149 million olive trees.
Sorry, Rohita?
There are nearly 149 million olive trees.
Okay. So, this is a national flower of Greece. It's called as Bear's Breech. And the scientific name is Acanthus mollis. So,
I've never eaten pita bread.
You haven't?
I mean, I had it.
Okay.
I've eaten once.
Okay. So these flowers are used in Greek decorations and as well as in temples. So, and they also represent wealth. Okay. And
National dolphin. Animal.
Yes, national animal is dolphin. So who knows any facts about dolphin?
Dolphins are not really
friendly.
Okay, one by one.
First, Rohita.
Dolphins are very friendly. Yes, okay. They have deep bones, but they don't bite me.
Okay, Sudarshan.
Dolphins communicate through various whistles and signals they send to one another. It's also the way they hunt. Dolphins hunt in packs, and they have a maneuver in which they sort of box the a huge school of fish, and then they eat.
Okay.
Packs of dolphins are kept so that they can defend each other from orcas or killer whales.
All right. So Anshu, you have something to say?
I have.
Dolphins are very intelligent.
Dolphins are surprising.
One by one. Okay, one by one. Ansh, first you go.
Ma'am, dolphins are very intelligent, and at the all aqua animals, they're only dolphins are able to hunt down the shark in the group.
Okay, next is Abir.
Dolphins have quite a few predators, including sharks and orcas, also called killer whales.
Okay, that's good to know.
So even orcas are sharks.
Yes, Abir?
Which is orca is actually a member of the dolphin family and not a whale.
Okay. Okay, so Rohita, you had something to say? Rohita?
Yes, ma'am. Dolphins are very friendly.
Yes, they are friendly. So you can see many of the dolphin shows which people go and visit, and they are very friendly to them.
They should be illegal, dolphin shows.
Yes. Does anyone else have anything to say about dolphin?
And they are also fast.
Not about dolphin, but about orcas.
Yeah, tell me.
Yes, ma'am. You know all the deep sea creatures? In that, if you go down inside, the first sea creature you'll see is the orca.
Okay.
First to protect themselves. Which is up is there.
All right. So this is a national bird. Okay, they phoenix. Have a national bird as a little phoenix. Owl also, and this is a phoenix. Yes, phoenix. This is but also represented in Harry Potter also. You might have seen it. So
yes, Dumbledore.
Yes, it's a mythological bird. It's not a real bird.
It's
a bird that is immortal.
Yes, they wanted to represent it as a, even the Greek can be reborn from the ashes. That's why they wanted it as a national bird. One more bird is little owl. So little owl is also one of the national birds.
I guess looking at its size, I guess it's the smallest owl in the world.
Yeah, maybe it might be. That's why it has a name Little Owl also. So with that, we have come to an end. Did you enjoy the tour?
Yeah, quite yes, short yes. though.
Yes,
quite
ma'am.
Short. It's 4:30, dude. Okay, so we have covered too many things actually. Okay, does anyone else have any new facts other than this?
Well, Greece
okay.
is a
center
yes, Rohita.
For many... Yes, Rohita. Ma'am,
Greece's
nickname is Hellas.
Greece's nickname is
Hellas.
Okay.
And we cannot wear high heels in Greece.
Okay. Okay.
Greeks are very happy people.
Uh-huh.
And Greek's coffee is very unique.
All right.
80% of Greece is made up of mountains and like nature.
That was in the PPT.
Okay. Prakar, you were saying something?
Greece is a center for many of these stories which are based up in the modern era. Like Harry Potter borrows some stuff from Greek mythology.
Uh-huh. And they are one of the sunniest places in the world.
Okay. Okay. So, do you want to see a video or is
Mom,
it
can fine? I tell a funny fact?
Video.
Yes.
Greek people are very scared to eat beans. The ancient Greeks.
Okay. Who else raised the hand? Prakar? Yes, Prakar?
I'm done.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm done. I gave up you.
Okay. Okay. Do you want to see a video? Like a 2-minute video of places in Greece?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Okay.
Then I'll write it down.
Yes. All right, so did you learn new things today about gods of Greece and all?
Yeah.
Ma'am.
Yes. So tomorrow we are going to visit Hungary, country named Hungary. Yes.
Any tasks?
Yeah, you can see, you can draw. Okay, no need to draw because it's a weekday, right? So you can look up which is the national animal of Hungary and also any other national symbols they have, like national bird or animal or flower.
The national animal of Hungary should be a hungry man.
It's not. Okay, so we'll meet tomorrow. Hope you enjoyed.
Can I tell my Greek word?
Yes, Rohita.
Ma'am, everybody knows about please in Greek. It's parakalo. Everybody knows that. And no means ohi. And my name is Milane.
Okay.
Thanks means efharisto. Okay means entaxai. Everything okay means olakala. Panamorphy is beautiful. Like beautiful means panamorphy. God means theos. And then I love to eat pizza. This is the only sentence which I know. Mau arasai na true pizza.
Okay. So how to say bye in Greece? Do you know Greek? Do you know that?
No, ma'am. I know.
How about thank you?
Arrivederci.
Okay. Then that's how we are saying bye today. Okay. Thank you, Rohita, for sharing with us.
Ma'am, I know many languages of
small. Oh, that's language. Great. Because learning a language is always a good thing.
And I know the national language of Hungary also.
Oh, that's great. So tomorrow we have few words about in Hungarian. So it will be very good. Okay. So tomorrow, we'll meet tomorrow. Hope you enjoyed the tour today. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Bye.
Okay, ma'am. Bye, ma'am. Have a nice
day. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye bye.
Thank you.